The IT Help Desk is an invaluable tool for organizations. But in order to provide the best service and quickest resolution, companies need to have a multi-tiered support structure. In this video, we'll look at the 5 levels of Help Desk support. One of the most important things for organizations the world over, which only keeps getting more and more important, is delivering excellent IT support for their customers. Whether it's fielding issues or equipping customers with the tools they need to find answers themselves, IT support is the first line of defense when it comes to keeping operations running smoothly. IT support specialists help customers with issues that range from simple hiccups, such as connection or login issues, to bigger and more complex problems that require a more detailed analysis. But because these problems vary so much in terms of complexity, having a single layer of IT support isn't an effective way to go about things. Instead, a tiered help desk infrastructure is needed. That's right, organizations the world over have figured out that a multi-tier IT support structure is the way to go. We're starting our list not at level 1, but at level 0, self-service and user-retrieved information. Level 0 includes every single tool that the company puts at the customer's disposal to help them fix the incident themselves, such as self-service portals or a service catalog. The key here is that there's little to no direct customer-to-employee interaction. The customer finds the answers themselves. For instance, say a customer needed information on how to properly replace a toner cartridge. They could head over to their self-service portal and find the answer in their knowledge base, instead of taking up an IT specialist's time. Thanks to a well-implemented level 0 support system, the customer has found a way to fix the problem on their own, without involving any personnel or support teams directly. IT support level 1. Frontline basic support. Level 1 is where personnel and support teams start to get directly involved in technical support tasks. This tier is customers' first direct contact with the company's employees, so it's important that those in charge of providing assistance are ready to fix these issues. In addition, they should also know when it's best to delegate the problem to somebody in a higher tier. Let's say, for example, that a customer is having trouble navigating an app and can't seem to find a way to accomplish their goal. Upon contacting customer technical support, they are met with an employee that walks them through the process. The problem was relatively simple and it did not require escalation of any kind. Thus, the issue is solved within the level 1 support tier. IT support level 2, advanced support. Level 2 is where things get a tad more complex. Personnel in this category generally provide in-depth troubleshooting and back-end support. Employees in this tier are usually much more knowledgeable of the company's hardware and software tools. An example of this. Upon receiving a ticket from a Level 1 support specialist, the Level 2 support analyst has learned that a customer has been trying to access their account, but has been apparently blocked by the company's anti-phishing software. The customer is, of course, not a scammer, but the system has mislabeled them as one. Thus, the Level 2 support specialist lifts the block on the customer's account after looking into the issue in detail. The issue is solved thanks to the technician's knowledge of the company's app and automated systems. IT support level 3, subject matter expert support. Level 3 is the highest level in terms of IT support. There is a level 4, but we'll get to that in a moment. Employees in this level not only know how the products and services of the company work, but they also have access to the highest level of technical resources. Usually, they create, maintain, and fix important elements that make up the structural integrity of apps and systems. Oftentimes, they may even participate in the creation of new software and fixes in networks, code, and other tools. So here's an example of where a level 3 technician might be involved. A customer encounters a bug in an app which puts the infrastructure's data in jeopardy. A level 3 specialist would not only fix this specific customer's problem, but also update and fix the app's code so as to not have this issue ever again. This can only be achieved with extensive knowledge of the app's architecture and the tickets elevated from levels 1 and 2 respectively. Some more examples of problems level 3 help desk support personnel need to solve are: looking into high-complexity hardware, code, and/or architecture issues, providing hotfixes to systems and apps to ensure their proper functioning, Server maintenance and resolving tickets escalated by level 1 and 2 help desk support personnel. And finally, let's talk about IT support level 4, external support. This tier is all about outside technical support provided but not supported by the company. For instance, a defective batch of printers and monitors that the company has purchased is presenting problems. As a consequence, the official vendors fix and/or replace the products. And there you have it. These are the 5 levels of IT support. Of course, every organization is different, and some might merge or even do away completely with some of these tiers. What does your IT support system look like? Do you have questions, comments, or experiences of your own you want to share? Please be sure to leave them in the comments below. And don't forget to click like and subscribe to InvGate Academy for more videos on the ins and outs of service management.